In South Australia's northern Spencer Gulf, there's a section of rocky reef that provides an important breeding ground for Australia's giant cuttlefish, Sepia apama. It's within and underneath these rocks that the cuttlefish lay their eggs.
Giant Australian cuttlefish are found right along Australia's Great Southern Reef. However, this is a distinct population only found in the northern Spencer Gulf, which makes them susceptible to localised threats. The Cuttlefish Coast Sanctuary and Upper Spencer Gulf Marine Park is therefore very important for the future of this species.
Until recently, people would look out from the shores of Point Loli and have no idea there were over 100,000 animals along this 8-kilometre stretch of rocky coastline. It's the only place in the world where cuttlefish gather in such large numbers. We now know that this is a really important annual event for giant cuttlefish in South Australia. Cephalopods, that's squid, cuttlefish and octopus, are considered to be the rock stars of the ocean because they live fast and die young. Cuttlefish live for just 12 to 18 months. So the reproductive success of the population that exists in any given year determines the population in the next year. Females arrive at the site at the beginning of winter, a little earlier than the males. The ratio of males to females is around 7 to 1. The really large males compete for females and will tend to try and defend a particular female or egg-laying site. These males compete with incredible visual displays. They're effectively trying to secure a mate and fend off any competitors. Cephalopods, including giant Australian cuttlefish, are live fast, die young species. This means they can be responsive to environmental stress, causing them to boom and bust dramatically. And scientists are actively tracking cuttlefish numbers. In the late 90s, a lot of commercial fishers started targeting cuttlefish in that area. They realised there was a developing market for cuttlefish and the catch started to go up. And this is a problem because if we're catching these animals on a spawning ground, there's a risk to the entire population. Every year, SARDI Aquatic Sciences send a team out to Point Loli to assess the population of the giant Australian cuttlefish. In the late 90s, the population estimate was around 180,000 and appeared stable. In 2005, the population dipped. But then from about 2009 onwards, the scientists started to see a concerning decrease in the population, dropping to just 13,000 animals in 2013, which was a decline to less than 10% of earlier estimates. Many questions were raised about what was causing the decline. Was it pollution, disease, aquaculture, fishing? Everything was being investigated. The area is highly utilised by a lot of different people and organisations, so there was a lot of speculation about what it might have been. Once the populations declined to that really low level, the management increased the protection of the area. After the closure, scientists saw the population come back incredibly quickly. While there wasn't any definitive link that fishing pressure was causing the population to decline, it was more of a precautionary approach.
A localised closure to protect the cuttlefish during breeding season has been in place since the 90s. Later, the Cuttlefish Coast became a sanctuary zone, part of the Upper Spencer Gulf Marine Park, protecting both the cuttlefish and habitat. Protections were further enhanced, extending a permanent fishing closure of cuttlefish over the whole northern Spencer Gulf. Thankfully, this unique giant Australian cuttlefish population is now fully protected right throughout their home range. In recognition of the work of community and government, the Cuttlefish Coast Sanctuary Zone was acknowledged by the federal government as having outstanding heritage significance to Australia and added to the National Heritage List.
Today, the aggregation continues to thrive, as does tourism, with local and international adventurers coming and braving the cold to snorkel and dive with these fascinating animals. It's the only place in the world where you can see tens of thousands of cuttlefish aggregating in such a small area.